Hello, my name's Dr. Simon Curtis, and today we're at the Rossdale's post-mortem room. We're going to meet somebody very special who's going to show us how to remove a hoof capsule. Hi Paige, how are you?
Very good.
Good. Paige Poss is a world-renowned hoof anatomist, and she studied the hoof capsule for many years. So tell us what you're going to do for us today then, Paige.
What I'm going to do is show you how I pull the hoof capsule so that I keep the structures intact and we can look at them and study them.
Well, I'm going to probably have to put this on because I've seen you do this before, and I know you need an extra pair of hands. Muscle, if not skill.
Especially okay. With the bigger feet like this, yeah, okay. Getting help is
all right,
awesome.
I'll get this on then, if I can figure out how it goes on. So I'll leave you to tell us what you do first.
I'm going to score the hoof capsule so that I can then pull the whole sole off and we can look at the detail that way. The other thing that I'm going to do is I like to do a lot of comparative things where I have hooves that are relatively healthy compared to hooves that have problems, and we're going to go over that later. But first we're going to talk about how we pull the hoof capsule. We're going to put the cadaver feet into the boiling water to soften the bonds between the lamina so that I can pull the capsule. I want to make sure I don't pull the pot onto me. It's been long enough. We're going to pull them out of the pot and let them cool off and clean them up to take them apart. So we've boiled them so that they'll easily pull apart and we get the detail of the structures underneath the hoof capsule. So what I've done is drawn a line, and that's just going to be my score line, and I'm going to Dremel so then I can pull off the sole in one go and have all the detail at the back of the foot.
And that is why this is called a leg vise.
So I've done my score line and I am going to be able to pull the hoof capsule, and the object is to get the whole sole come off in one piece. So Simon is going to help me pull the hoof capsule, which is so much easier than wrestling this by myself. So
I've got to stress this down here, yeah?
Now I'm going to score.
Is that enough?
That's enough for now.
Okay.
Try rolling it a little bit more.
A bit more like this, yeah?
Yeah. Hold on.
Oh, I can see, I can see it give.
And you can feel it too.
Yeah.
It's like butter.
I'm worried I'm going to somersault backwards at any second.
No, that's why rolling down helps you. So roll it a little bit more.
Yeah, a little bit more pressure.
Okay. Let's take those out. Okay. I'm going to shift it just here, so we can work on the corner a little bit more.
All right. You tell me where I need to put these
shoe pillars. So why don't I set them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
And so we're trying to roll this corner off.
Am I doing all right as an assistant?
Just absolutely pull it a little bit more.
All right, more like this.
A little bit more. Ooh, yep.
Slipped off.
See, it's
move it a little bit.
No, I think you're good. Get it. Yeah, it's deeply in there. It's these big feet that are a little bit harder to.
Yeah, you wait till we see the next one.
I know. All I can say is I'm glad I have help to do the next one.
Ooh,
there we go.
That's
okay.
Gone.
So we're gonna put that back.
Right. Right. We're in there. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we're stressed.
Yep, hold on, it's right in here.
Because the other one really popped, didn't it, once it went?
Yep, there we go. Can you feel it? It's starting to go. There.
There we go, now it's gone.
Yeah. Do we need to tighten it more? You want to tighten it? Yeah, that helps.
There it goes.
So I've now pulled the hoof sole off, and we can look at all the detail, even of the back of the foot, the caudal aspect of the foot. You can see the corresponding aspect of the internal sole. And now you can compare inside and outside. So here is the sole after we've pulled it off. What's cool about doing it this way is that now we can look at all the sensitive structures of the sole and the whole caudal aspect of the foot, but now we see the corresponding insensitive structures of the sole also, and you can compare. Next, we're going to pull off the hoof wall. So this is your junction between your lamellar chorea and your coriums. Sometimes this goes smoothly, sometimes not. Again, the healthier the foot, the harder it is to pull the wall off, even when you've prepped it. It's not doing so well. That's a good thing for the horse.
Well, I don't think the horse is that concerned at the moment.
Well, when he was alive, it means his feet were attached better than average. This is when I love thoroughbreds. I don't like working on them for keeping their feet together, but when I'm taking them apart, they're awesome.
And so you've come to the home of the thoroughbred, Newmarket, and we've given you two non-thoroughbreds.
Exactly. I thought I was going to have, it's like butter pulling apart a thoroughbred foot a lot of times. It really, there's a huge difference. The trick is trying to pull the hoof wall off without doing too much damage, and sometimes it's just really hard to keep everything pretty and intact, but I work hard to keep the integrity so you can see the detail. Look at, this is the coronary cushion with your papillae, and underneath the hairline, those short papillae are your perioplic papillae. And then here's your lamina. Some of them, you saw one yesterday, just.
Yeah.
Not this one. It's about to let go. It was about to flap. But see how little blood there is? It's not as Sorry.
Get back on, can you?
I did not expect it to do that.
In the making of this video, we've had lots of help. In particular, we've had it from Paige Poss, so I'd like to thank you for your help. But we've also had the use of Rossdale's post-mortem room, and we've been sponsored by Strong's Home. I hope you enjoyed this video. We're going to have lots more videos on the anatomy of the horse's foot. If you have any questions, please put them into the comments box below. Otherwise, if you liked it, please share and subscribe.